House Musical Productions, Mary Poppins. Please take a moment to turn off all mobile phones, pagers, who has a pager anymore? And smartwatches, yep, that's more current, smartwatches, as to not interfere with the magic of this show. Photography or videoing is not permitted throughout the performance. All right, now that's done and in order, you can enjoy the show. Cheerio, Governor.
In the east, there's a mist coming in, like something is brewing and about to begin. Can't put me finger on what lies in store, but I feel what's to happen all happened before. A father, a mother, a daughter, a son, the threads of their lives are all ravelling undone. Something is needed to twist them as tight as a string you might use when you're flying a kite. Chim chimani, chim chim, jari chim jaru.
Jane, that's right.
Get back here, little blighters. You've got to do your lesson.
I can't do my lessons if I'm flying.
Miss Lark, and how's Sir Willoughby today?
Oh, very well. Thank you, Bert.
By Jove, is that the beauteous Miss Lark I spy on the horizon?
Oh, Admiral. Willoughby.
Morning, Admiral. How's it looking?
Well, dark clouds brewing at number 17. Storm warnings overdue.
All London's byways where I doffs me cap, this one's the hardest to find on a map. Cherry Tree Lane, as sweet as a song, but the nannies who come here, they don't stay for long. Chim chimani, chim chim, chari chim chari.
From me for the last time.
And who gets stuck with the children with no nanny in the house? Me, that's who!
I've had my say, Mrs. Brill, and that's all I'll say. I'm done with this house forever!
Well, good riddance then. And mind you don't stumble on the way out.
Katie Nana? Where are you going? Katie Nana? Oh,
Katie Nana! Katie Nana's gone, and is it any wonder? Driven half demented by your children's pranks.
Do you really think I made another blunder? What on earth am I to say to Mr. Banks? George, dear, I'm feeling so bereft. Dear, another nanny's left. Dear, every nanny goes. Well, unlucky, I suppose.
We are never going to find a perfect nanny!
Nonsense!
Yeah!
precision and order. That's all that I ask. The running of a household, a straightforward task. The children, the servants, are all your domain, whilst I remain the sovereign of Cherry Tree Lane. Coat! The simple truth is you've engaged 6 nannies in the last 4 months and they've all been unqualified disasters. A nanny should govern, a nanny should rule. A nanny is a paragon who suffers no fool. A nanny's a stalwart our children would gain from having such a nanny in Cherry Tree Lane.
Of course, George.
So take control of the situation. Use your authority when interviewing staff. You know your role. They know their stations. Efficiency and forethought cut the jobs in half. Briefcase!
I thought Katie Nana was always firm with the children. She always looked so cross.
Winifred, dear, never confuse efficiency with a liver complaint. Now, brother!
If only we could find someone like your old nanny.
I'm afraid that's not realistic, my dear. Very few women alive can manage Miss Andrews' standards of efficiency. Besides, we can never afford anybody of her caliber.
Precision and order, he wants nothing less. It's like an army barracks. Yes, and we're in the mess. No wonder the nannies are driven insane. We're living in a metaphor in Cherry Tree Lane.
Winifred, if you do want to please me.
You know I do, George.
Very well. Then place this advertisement in the Times stating that Jane and Michael Banks require the best possible nanny at the lowest possible wage.
We'd better get them out before they make another mistake.
Yes, and I would state the references are required.
What's that you're holding, dear?
We've written our own advertisement.
What on?
Oh, please, I think we should hear it.
Winifred, enough of your theatrics.
It won't hurt to listen.
Wanted, a nanny for 2 adorable children.
Adorable. Well, that's debatable, I must say.
If you want this choice position, have a cheering disposition, rosy cheeks, no warts.
That's the part that I put in.
Play games, all sorts. You must be kind, you must be witty, very sweet and fairly pretty.
What of all the ridiculousness?
Oh, please, George.
Take us on outings, give us treats.
Sing songs, bring sweets. Never be cross or cruel. Never feed us castor oil or gruel.
Love us as a son and daughter.
And never smell of barley water.
I put that bit in too. If you won't scold and dominate us, we will never give you cause to hate us. We won't hide your spectacles so you can't see.
Put toads in your bed or pepper in your tea.
Hurry, nanny, many thanks.
Sincerely,
Jane
and Michael.
Thanks.
That's quite enough Tommy Rot for one day. You two go upstairs and let me get to work.
They were only trying to help.
It won't help anybody to make me late. Now, where's my hat?
Hat?
George, dear.
Hat?
Hat!
I thought you put it down here.
Hat, hat!
I'm sure a bowler hat can't simply disappear.
Do you think I'll find a nanny?
There it is.
Doesn't run away.
He's brushed it with boot polish.
Precision and order, that's all that.
Sovereign, mind you use the day well.
You remain the sovereign.
I shall return at 6 o'clock sharp.
He remains the sovereign.
Good morning.
Yes.
I've come in answer to the advertisement.
What advertisement? We haven't placed an advertisement. Well, not yet.
George and Winifred Banks live here, do they not?
Mr. and Mrs. Banks live here, yes.
And you are looking for a nanny?
Well, I suppose.
Very well, then, now, let's see. Play games, all sorts, which I most certainly can. Take us on outings, give us treats.
Michael, it's our advertisement.
Rosy cheeks and fairly pretty. There's no objection on that score, I hope.
No, none at all.
Well, I'm glad to hear it.
But you'll have to take that up with Mrs. Banks. She manages all that side of things. Nothing domestic has anything to do with me. Mind you get the references.
I make it a rule never to give references.
But I thought it was usual.
A very old-fashioned idea, to my mind. The best people never require them now.
I see. You'll have every third Thursday evening off from 5 until 9.
The best people give every second Wednesday from 6 until late, ma. And that is what I shall take.
Oh, well, it's all settled then.
Yes, well, as long as I am satisfied. I'll see the children now, thank you.
Of course. You'll find they're very nice children. Children! 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 Now this is...
Mary Poppins. Jane, don't stare. And close your mouth, Michael. We are not a codfish. Best foot forward. Spit spot.
Mrs. Graham. We have a new nanny.
So she passed her interview, then?
Or I did.
Than I was expecting. Who's responsible for that?
Mrs. Me. I am. I like to keep things neat.
Do you indeed? Well, I look forward to making use of that. If there's one thing I appreciate, it's a child whose word I can depend on. Oh. And who is he when he's at home?
That's Valentine. He's mine.
By the look on his face, I am not sure he would agree with you.
He's just a doll. And I don't want to play with him now.
Treat him like that, and he might not want to play with you. Now, first things first. I always say the proper place to hang a hat is on a hat stand.
There's nothing in it.
We better keep an eye on this one. She's tricky.
Mary Poppins? How could you know what we wanted in a nanny? When we made our list, we said...
Your list! I am not an item in the weekly shop, thank you very much.
How did you come then? It was as if the wind just blew you here.
It did. Now stand over there. Just as I thought, a noisy, mischievous, troublesome little boy...
You're making that up!
Now you. Thoughtless, short-tempered, and untidy.
I don't believe you. Let me see.
By the time the wind has blown the weather vane around, I'll show you, if I can. No matter what the circumstance, for one thing I'm renowned. My character is spit spot spick and span.
What about your measurement, Mary Poppins?
Oh. I'm practically perfect in every way.
Practically perfect.
So people say. Each virtue virtually knows no bound. Each trait is great and sound. I'm practically perfect from head to
and proper and never too stern. Well educated, yet willing to learn. I'm clean and honest, my manner refined, and I wear shoes of the sensible kind. I suffer no nonsense, and whilst I remain, there's nothing else I feel I need explain. I'm practically perfect in every way. Practically perfect, that's my forte. Uncanny nannies are hard to find. Unique yet meek, unspeakably kind. I'm practically perfect, not slightly soiled. Running like an engine that's just been freshly oiled. I'm so practically perfect in every way. My credentials. Perhaps you have a few questions.
Not temperamental.
Never.
Not grouchy or gruff.
Ready for court.
Will you stay tender when the going gets tough?
Quite the contrary.
Do you read stories without a big fuss?
Mm-hmm.
Or have objections to playing with us?
I like games.
Yes, I win.
But I choose them.
That's not fair!
Some minor improvements may not go amiss, but at all times you must remember this.
You're practically perfect in every way.
I guarantee.
Practically perfect. We hope you'll stay.
Each virtue virtually is the bond. Each trait is great. Practically perfect, and here's my game. By the time I leave here, you both will be the same. You'll be practically perfect.
Practically perfect.
You will be practically perfect in every way.
Chiminey, chim, chiminey, chim, chim, charoo. I does what I likes, and I likes what I do. Today, I'm a screever, and as you can see, a screever's an artist of highest degree. And it's all me own work, from me own memory.
Oh, lummy, not these again.
Oh, come on, Mr. Parkkeeper. It's just me pictures as it always is. There's no harm in them.
I'll be the judge of that. This is my park, and I say you're interfering with a public railing. I want them removed this air. That is... just you watch it. Just you watch it.
Stay right where you are. I know that silhouette anywhere. Mary Poppins!
It's nice to see you, Bert.
Well, I must say, you do look swell.
How does he know? He can't know. You've only just arrived.
I wasn't born 1 minute before I walked into your house, Michael Banks. Have you met these two, Bert?
Of course I have. I've seen them about chasing a kite.
Isn't it a real kite?
It isn't a real kite! So, what are you two up to?
Mary Poppins says it's a game. It's called A Walk in the Park.
Some game. I'd rather eat spinach.
Come on, Bert. You're due for a break, and you promised you'd take me out when we met again. Or had you forgotten?
Of course I ain't, Mary. But...
Oh, dear. Is that all you've got? Never mind my treat. And no one's charging for the trees or the sky, are they?
Mary Poppins, he isn't really coming with us.
And why shouldn't he?
Well, to start with, he's very dirty, isn't he? Father would never approve.
What's that?
You can't come with us. You're too dirty, and we don't want to go to the stinky park anyway.
Oh, yes, you do. Because when you walk with Mary Poppins, you go to places you've never dreamed of. And if she says it's a game, she's got something in mind. You can be certain of that.
That's a picture of the park, isn't it?
That's not the park. Not our park, anyway. Look, that tree's a much darker green, and the sky's quite a different blue. And of course...
I think you'll find it's just the way I've drawn it. All that it takes is a spark. And something plain as a park becomes a wonderland. All you have to do is look anew, then you'll understand. Why, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. Mary makes your heart so light.
Oh, really?
When the day is grey and ordinary, Mary makes the sun shine bright.
You do talk nonsense, Bert.
Oh, happiness is blooming all around her. The daffodils are smiling at the dark.
I haven't the faintest idea.
When Mary holds your hand, you feel so grand. Your heart starts beating like a big brass band.
You've enough brass for all of us.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. No wonder that it's Mary that we love. The morning in May,
I feel like I could fly.
Have you ever seen the grass so green?
More a bluer sky.
Bluer sky.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. Better days I've never known.
You can ask the clouds and statuary.
Nothing's ever set in stone.
You do look tip-top, if I may say so, Mary.
Thank you, Bert. And you may.
Each man out with his dog will stand agog to see a statue take a gentle jog.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary.
No wonder that it's Mary that we love.
It's a jolly holiday with you, Bert. Gentlemen like you are for you. Oh, you're just a diamond in the rough. Underneath your blood,
blood is blue.
You'd never think of pressing your advantage. Forbearance is the hallmark of your creed. A lady needn't fear when you are near. Your sweet gentility is crystal clear.
It's crystal clear.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with
you, Bert.
Your marbles.
Oh, this is that Mary Poppins's fault, ain't it? I knew we'd have trouble when you first arrived, and now we've got a statue, Miss Eyre. Oh, lummy!
Will you play with us again?
Of course. I'm not going anywhere.
Then we'll see you soon. Goodbye, Amelius.
Goodbye.
Anything can happen if you let it.
How long will you stay?
We'll see.
You won't leave us, will you, Mary Poppins?
I shall stay until the wind changes. Now run along, you.
Good night, Jane. Good night, Michael.
Good night, Mary.
Good night, Bert.
Jane and Michael wish to say good night.
Tell them you've given me the message.
George, please.
All right. Oh, Daddy, we've had a fantastic day. We sang with the busker, danced with the statue, and met Queen Victoria. You wouldn't have approved, but we were just having so much fun.
If you know that, then why did you do it?
Daddy, could I have a kite? A proper one?
Could you fly it?
You could always teach me.
When would I have time to do that?
Daddy, who's the father of Nelius?
Would you let me get on? Good night.
Poor Michael. All he cares about is flying kites. And his beloved astronomy, of course.
I used to love astronomy at his age, too. But my nanny, Miss Andrew, soon beat it out of me.
I suppose we do need a nanny, George. It is out of the question to do without one.
Don't be ridiculous. Of course we need a nanny. So the wives can do charity work and entertain. Which reminds me, how's your tea party coming along?
Well, I'm not so sure. It seems so odd to send out invitations to people I hardly know.
Ah, but they're people you should know. Remember, by your friends shall ye be judged.
But that's the point. They're not my friends. Actually, I heard today from Clemmy Bunting. She's rehearsing a new play at the moment, and I thought I might go and ask her.
I don't know how many times I have told you. I wish you would sever all connection with that part of your life.
George, I was an actress, you know. Lots of people might find that interesting. But you always talk to me as though I should be ashamed of it.
Well, it's not something you should be proud of. Winifred, dearest, I was only thinking of you. I want people to admire you, to respect you.
Yes, I know, George, but sometimes it's hard to be...
It's not hard. It's your job, to be Mrs. Banks.
And what is your job?
To pay for everything! Ah! What is it?
I was only going to kiss you.
Oh, very well. Are you going to say something to Mary Poppins about this afternoon?
I don't think so.
Very well. Just make sure she's doing things our way, and not hers. What good are rules if you can bend them? We need a nanny who's disciplined and stern. With boys and girls, you don't befriend them. I'm afraid that Mary Poppins has a lot to learn.
Being Mrs. Banks should be an easy road. And yet it's one which I don't seem too good at on the whole. I have a comfy home. I have a simple life. I have a name which tells the world I'm someone else's wife. Being Mrs. Banks, what does that entail? Facing tests of character, I always seem to fail. And as for his best people, well, I'd like to say no thanks. They're not exactly my idea of being Mrs. Banks.
I still feel as if I'm dreaming so much.
Change, tides can turn, sink or swim, see what they learn. Me, I was told when I was small, just learn a trade. So I learnt them all. Chim chimini, chim chim, jari chim.
Morning, Bert. Swabbing the decks today, I see.
Gotta keep the street ship shape, Admiral.
Tell me, how are things aboard number 17? All plain sailing with Mary Poppins, I trust?
There's rough weather on every voyage, Admiral.
Ah, Miss Lark. What those children need is a touch of the cat and a night on the yard arm.
What those children need, Admiral, is a touch of happiness. Willoughby! Sandwiches too early. They'll get stale before the guests arrive.
Everything's under control, Mom.
And what about the cake?
Cooling on the tray, waiting to be iced.
And you're quite sure you know how to ice it?
Quite sure. And in case you're worried, I have not been exchanged by the fairies for a total nincompoop!
No. Well, I'll just go up and check the drawing room.
I would like to be helpful.
And I would like to be rich. But the good Lord thought otherwise.
Right. Mother wants me in the drawing room.
Well, she can't have me. I've enough of me plate as it is.
She says you can tell Robertson A what to do.
Oh, she does she? Well, why don't I go have a smoke near the gasworks for good measure?
Please, Mrs. Brill, I don't mind. Honest.
All right. I'll give you one task and one task only, and so help me, if you get this wrong, I'll swing for you and sing as they pull the lever.
What is it? Mrs. Brill.
Take the icing tools and put them next to the cake. And I'll need a bowl of hot water to warm them. I'll ice the cake when I get back. Do you think you can manage all that?
Is that all?
For you, yes. For me, no. Once the cake's done, I'll have the sandwiches next, because Madam wants them fresh, which means I can't start them until there's no time to finish them. I swear, a slave in ancient Rome was on a pleasure cruise compared to my life in this house.
Well, don't just stand there, Robinson, eh?
Right. No.
What are you looking for?
A bowl for the hot water. Bowl,
Michael,
bowl.
Michael, why don't we make the icing?
Because we don't know how to.
Don't be so feeble. Get the eggs. Bowl. If Mrs. Brill can do it, it can't be that hard.
Are there eggs in icing?
There are in mine.
I don't think Mrs. Brill will thank you.
Then she will be guilty of great ingratitude.
Is it supposed to look like that?
Oh, it does not look like that when Mrs. Brill does it!
Don't be impertinent and get me the cake!
Oh! Honestly, Miss Jane, I was only trying to be helpful!
Necessary, Mum.
How can you be so unkind when you know how important my party is? You deserve some very nasty medicine. Just you wait until bedtime.
Oh, I don't think we should wait until then, Mum. Why not go up and get changed? We'll clear up here, won't we?
But I'm not ill and I won't take it and you can't make me.
In that, as in so many things, your information is faulty. Open.
But strawberry ice.
Now you?
I'm not sure I like strawberry ice.
I'm not sure I care. Open.
Lime cordial.
Now, off we go, you two. Michael, I know you like to keep things neat. Jane?
I told you she was tricky. Must we?
Can't Robinson A do it when he wakes up? He is a servant.
With that attitude, you'll get through a lot of staff before you're very old. Besides, in every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You'll find the fun and snap. The job's a game. And every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake, a lark, a spree. It's very clear to see that a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way. My point exactly. The honeybees that fetch the nectar from the flower to the comb never tire of ever buzzing to and fro, because they take a little nip from every flower that they sip, and hence they find task is not a grind. For a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in the most delightful ways. It's hot.
Delightful way.
to play our next game.
What game?
A visit to the bank.
That's not a game. Did Daddy agree? If he did,
you must have put it into his head somehow.
What an impertinent thing to say. Me putting ideas into other people's heads. Really?
Them to the hilt. For shrewd investment and advice, they'll pay our price.
The bedrock on which banks are built.
Banks, the word! I see Herbert Hustler is coming in again today. Have you made your decision?
I believe so, sir.
Good, good. Make sure it's the right one.
I won't let you down, sir.
In every transaction, credit or debt,
what objections can you have? My security is more than adequate. Und Latin America is an expanding market. What is the matter? Have you no courage?
But Mr. von Hustler, what I haven't been able to grasp is, what exactly is your final product?
What do you think? Money, of course.
Yes, of course, money. But I wonder, making money out of money, is it really enough?
Are you man enough to be a banker? A man has dreams of building an empire to make his name in many distant lands. And in the new world, I am told, will soon find gold, then seize a chance with both our hands.
Assessing the market, limit the risk.
Have you come to your decision, Mr. Banks? Oh, there's a town of good people whose future depends on your hands.
I know that, and...
Give us this chance. You won't regret it. Oh, the factory could be running in 3 weeks and expanding before the year's out. Oh, please, Mr. Banks. Oh, give it everything I've got. Believe me.
I do believe you, Mr. Northbrook, and I've tried to find a way, but there just simply isn't the collateral.
What about my workforce? Decent men who want a better life. They're my collateral. My men have dreams to earn an honest living. A wife and kids, an home to call their own. If you'd invest in us today, it paves our way. I promise we'd repay the loan.
I'm sorry, Mr. Northbrook, but what are you doing here? Can't you see that I'm busy?
No, we're done. And no man should be too busy for his own children anyway. What are you here for, young man? Have you come for some money as well?
Hardly. What would they need money for?
Well, it's never too early to learn its value.
I know the value of this. Sixpence.
No, that's its worth. Its value is in how you spend it. Do good, and may you have good luck.
And what do you say to Mr. Northbrook?
Thank you.
I'll wait outside.
I'm going to have
the permit. Really, Mary Poppins, I am not without a sense of humour.
Aren't you, Daddy?
No, I am not. But when I was a little boy, I would have never have dared interrupt my father.
Were you ever a little boy?
Of course I was. But my nanny, Miss Andrew, kept me out of my father's way. And he'd have been very annoyed if she hadn't.
What about your mother?
Oh, well, I don't think I saw either of them more than once a week.
Didn't they mind?
Mind? They were glad to be rid of me.
Then who kissed you goodnight, Miss Andrew?
No, certainly not.
There was never any time for hugs and kisses and all that soppy nonsense. And what's the matter?
Poor Daddy.
Poor? Poor? That's what made me the man I am today, eh, Mary Poppins?
Yes, I'm afraid it did.
All right, you've seen where I work. I have a great deal to do.
Daddy, when you're investing the bank's money, what are you looking for? A good man or a good idea?
I suppose I should say a good idea, but a good man is much, much rarer, much more valuable.
Come along, children.
Mr. Von Hassler, I've considered your arguments, but I'm afraid my answer is no.
So, you don't recognize a good idea, then?
No, but I recognize a good man when I see one.
You will regret this, Herr Banks.
A man with dreams that life hasn't broken. A man with hopes, ambitions to fulfill. A man you're certain at first glance deserves a chance. Now, Mr. Northbrook, when exactly could you get the factory open?
Thank you, sir. You won't regret it.
Tuppence a bag.
There, that horrible old woman.
Good point. And for your information, she is not in the least horrible.
But she's just a bundle of rags.
When will you learn to look past what you've seen?
Early each day to the steps of St. Paul's, the little old bird woman comes. In her own special way, to the people she calls. Come, buy my bags full of crumbs. Come, feed the little bird, show her you care, and you'll be glad if you do. The young ones are hungry, their nests are so bare. All it takes is tuppence from you. Feed the birds, tuppence a bag. Tuppence, tuppence, tuppence a bag. Feed the birds, that's what she cries. While overhead her birds fill the skies.
What are you doing? Giving her my sixpence? What a waste!
That's a matter of opinion. Here, one bag.
Oh,
can tell her yourself, because here she comes now.
Isn't that Miss Lark's dog, Willoughby?
Don't interrupt when somebody's barking. You were saying? Really? Well, if she keeps running off like that, perhaps it would be best if you kept her on a lead.
We're lobby.
Here she comes now.
Ooh. Willoughby. It's all right. Mummy's here. You know, sometimes you'd almost think it could talk.
But can Willoughby really talk?
Of course he can. Getting him to stop's the problem.
How'd you learn short dog?
How do you think? Master the grammar.
Practice when you can.
And avoid mongrels.
Far too much slang.
Oh, no, come along. We can't stand here all day talking shop.
Talking shop? What a silly expression.
There's nothing silly about it in the least.
What do you buy in a talking shop?
Conversations, of course.
Well, I've never seen a talking shop.
Well, there is only one, and it belongs to Mrs. Corry.
Who's Mrs. Corry?
Who's Mrs. Corry? Mrs. Corry is older than anybody in the entire world. She talked to William before she went to Conquering, to Vlad before he went impaling, and to Alexander when he went so grand.
We'll have to call at her shop in the park.
There is no shop in the park.
Remember, anything can happen if you let it. To you, Mrs. Corry.
No, no, no. If it isn't Mary Poppins. Oh, it's Tina and Michael Banks.
She knows us.
Oh, and how's poor little Georgie?
Who?
Georgie Banks, your father. He used to give his nanny the slip and come into my shop here in secret.
That can't have been the same George Banks. That was 40 years ago. And no one can remember back that far.
Listen, dearie, I remember everything. I remember Georgie used to love my gingerbread. I wonder if we've got any left today. Now, 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 where are those lazy daughters of mine? Annie, Fanny, come, 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 look lively.
Yes, Mother.
There you are, gingerbread pieces with gingerbread stars. No, 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 no. Georgie always saved his stars. Now, Mary Poppin, what can I do for you?
Well, I did want an ounce of conversations.
Well, I'm out of conversation and I'm right out of words too. You see, I've had a lot of chatterboxes in here today, but let me see what we have left. Oh, I do have some letters and a little bit of back chat. Okay, okay, an ounce, you say. That'll be 15 letters. Go on, take your pick.
Jane, you can choose 7.
I got a D, G, R, U, C, L, and I.
They are good. You can't make a conversation out of them.
Your turn, Michael. 7 more.
I got an A, F, S, E, T, O,
and I'll choose an X. Oh, yes. Now, what words can we make?
Well, I see dog and cat.
Raptoplex, that's 9.
Lepitophorus, that's 11. Nearly there.
Those don't count. You made them up.
And where do you think words come from in the first place? Golly, golly, gosh, somebody had to make them up.
You know, you can always use the same letter more than once. Now, let me see. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
That's not a word.
Of course it's a word. And unless I'm very much mistaken, I think it's going to prove to be a rather useful one.
When trying to express oneself, it's frankly quite absurd to leaf through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation keen. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
But it doesn't mean anything.
It can mean exactly what you want it to. When Stone Age men were chatting, simply grunting would suffice.
Though if they heard this word, they might have used it once or twice.
I'm sure Egyptian pharaohs would have grasped it in a jiff. Then every single pyramid would bear this hieroglyph. Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Say it and wild animals would not seem so ferocious. Had some further flourishes, it's pseudococcocious.
Your breath before you speak in case it's halitosis.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Of course, you can say it backward, which is suyo-ecadilai-pitsecadilagafilagrepus.
She may be tricky, but she's bloody good.
So when the cat has got your tongue, there's no need for dismay. Just summing up this word and then you've got a lot to say.
Break out those 18 consonants and 16 vowels as well, and put them in an order which is very hard to spell.
S.
S.
U.
U.
P.
P.
E. E-R-A-C-A-L-I-F-R-A-G-I-N-I-S-T-I-C-E-X-P-I-A-L-I-D-O-C-I-O-U-A.
Smarty pants!
S-U-P-E-S-U-P-E-R-A-L-I-S-T-I-O-U-S.
Cali,
River Cali, yes, we're listening. Winds may blow, but who's to know exactly what they're bringing? Good news or bad, happy or sad, the pendulum keeps swinging.
Right. Put the steps there
right.
And stand back.
Right.
You are never to go near that vase, nor anyone else but me neither.
No.
That is a heirloom.
Heirloom?
Heirloom.
And while I do this, stay totally immobile.
Immobile?
Immobile.
Do not move a muscle.
Muscle?
Muscle.
Muscle.
Do not breathe. Do you hear me?
I might as well be dead.
Don't give me any ideas.
A game is played, a change is made, but still the road is long. And though they might still fly a kite, sometime the wind's too strong.
George, what's happened? Are you ill?
No. Should I be?
Well, of course not. Only why on earth are you home so early? Is everything all right?
No, everything's all wrong.
My dear, what is it?
Well, if you must know...
Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down.
If you must know, I refused a German chap a loan at the bank. Seems he went to our chief rivals. They gave him the money and, well, it turned into a gold mine.
Well, they can't expect you to get it right every time.
Can't they? That's exactly what they expect.
Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Of course, your mother.
Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious. If you say it loud enough.
That is quite loud enough. Go to your room.
But wait, what, Jesse?
I don't care what you adjust. Upstairs now. Where's my briefcase? I just put it here. Michael, Jane, won't you give it to me? Must I put up with this behavior? You're their mother. Can't you do something about it?
Well, I can try not shouting for a start.
Mary Poppins, you're here to teach these children manners. And just look at them. They're a pair of little savages. If I had my way, you'd be out of this house and...
George! You're tired. Mary Poppins, don't bring the children down tonight. Mr. Banks is quite exhausted. Perhaps you could keep them occupied.
I hope you hadn't forgotten, Mum. Tonight's my evening out.
What?
Oh, dear, I had forgotten. I suppose the best people wouldn't ask you to change your plans.
No, Mum, they wouldn't.
I thought not.
That's not fair! Daddy loses his temper and we're shut up in the nursery. Daddy's mean and rotten and I hate him!
Jane, take that back this instant. I will not have you criticise your father.
Why not? He criticises you. Last week he said you were neither use nor ornament.
How dare you?
I heard him say it and so did you.
Sometimes people say things they don't mean. Take the children upstairs, please, Mary Poppins. George?
What is it?
I thought you might like to talk about it.
What would be the point?
Perhaps I can help.
Don't be ridiculous.
George, I'm serious. If you have troubles, I'd like to share them.
Oh, you share them. The fact is, I've been suspended without salary until a bank have decided what to do with me.
Twists and turns,
ups and downs. One moment smiles, next moment frowns. But bad-tempered faces better change quick, 'cause when the wind changes, the face might just stick. Chim chimity, chim chim, charry chim charu.
It's not fair! You're going out and we get left on our own.
You've plenty of toys to play with.
I don't want to. They're boring.
They might say the same about you.
Why does Daddy get so cross? Fathers are supposed to look after their children, not yell at them all the time.
Maybe. But have you asked yourself, who looks after the fathers when things go wrong?
The mothers, I suppose.
Not the children.
Wouldn't that be rather upside down?
Sometimes families are upside down. For a while, anyway.
I don't want to be in an upside down family. I wish I could run away. Why don't you? Somebody might adopt you. But you'd miss me. No, I wouldn't. I could have your toys.
No, you could not.
Yes, I could, and I jolly well would. Give that to me! Now look what you've done!
That is no way to treat Valentine. What has he ever done to you?
He's just a doll, silly. He couldn't do anything.
That's it, you two. Now into bed at once.
But we haven't had
our milk. There'll be no butts and no milk either. If you can't be good, you may as well be sorry.
I wish you'd just leave us alone!
Be careful of the things that you wish for. Poor Valentine. Here, go inside and make yourself presentable.
Well, I won't go to sleep and you can't make me.
In that, as in so many things,
your information
is faulty.
Playing the game, taking your turn. Some children lose, some children learn. Treat the toys nicely and maybe they'll treat you the same. Playing the game.
Are you feeling any better, Valentine?
Much better, thank you.
Tempers are frayed, tempers are lost. Nobody stops to think of the cost.
But they tore my arm again.
Oh dear. Children who lose their temper will lose everything else in the end.
They're not playing the game, not playing fair. Not with the doll, nor with the bear.
Thrown on the floor and neglected. Playing the game.
Please tell them, Mary Poppins.
Why don't you tell them?
What's going on? What's happened to all the toys?
Make them go to school and get back in their box.
Why? You've hurt them and called their names. Now it's their turn.
Summon the toys. Now is the time to tell.
Indeed.
Smoke is all billowed and curled. Between pavements and stars is the chimney sweep's world, where there's hardly no day or hardly no night. There's things up in shadows and halfways in light. On the rooftops of London.
Sight.
Oh, so you're a sweep now, are you?
Best view in the world, eh? Who gets to view it? The birds, the stars, and the chimney sweeps. Nothing to beat it, eh?
Now as the ladder of life has been strung, you may think I sweeps on the bottommost rung. Though I spend me life in the ashes and smoke, in this all white world, there's no happier bloke.
Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheree. A sweep is as lucky can be. Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheroo.
Good luck will rub off when he shakes hands with you.
Or blow me a kiss. And that's lucky too. Oh, so you're going then?
The wind has changed.
But the good kids, Mary.
Would I be bothering with them if they weren't? But I can't help them if they won't let me. And there's no one so hard to teach as a child who knows everything.
So?
So, they've got to do the next bit on their own.
Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheree.
When you're with a sweep, you're in glad company.
Goodbye, Bert.
Chim, chim. Chim chim cheree, when you're with a sweep, you're in glad company. Nowhere is there a more happier crew than them two sings chim chim cheree, chim cheroo. Chim chim annie, chim chim cheree.
Where's Mary Poppins?
Gone.
Gone? Doesn't that take the blooming biscuit?
Mrs. Brill, what does au revoir mean?
Why?
Because that's what it says in this note. Dear Jane and Michael, keep playing the games. Au revoir, Mary Poppins.
Well, it's French, I know that much. luck, or God bless you, or now I remember, until we meet again. Now get inside before you catch your death.
Makes life easier for both of us.
Mrs. Brill, it is her, isn't it?
Well, I don't know who else.
Why is it such a secret? Do you think that she's returned to get things back the way they were?
The note says, till we meet again.
I just know it must be her.
Oh, my goodness, should he hear any moment? Now, where is George? You're going to be surprised.
Winifred, you know I hate surprises at the best of times.
Oh, not this one, George. I do believe you're going to be proud of me for once. Precision and order, it's perfectly true. Can really make a difference. I found her for you. Clear thinking, sound judgment, and now we'll regain a home you can be proud of in Cherry Tree Lane. Into the hall. I want her to find everything. Spit, spot, spick and span.
Spick and span.
Your sense of excitement
is hard to contain. Order is returning. Wonder is returning. Someone is returning.
It is to meet you at last. I do hope you had a good journey.
I never enjoy travel. And you must be poor George's wife. Your flower beds are disgracefully untidy. Take my advice. Plant evergreens. Or better still, plant nothing there at all. Just a plain cement courtyard.
But dear Miss Andrew, I'm so fond of flowers.
Then you're a very silly woman. Where did George go?
I'm afraid he had a rather urgent appointment.
For which no doubt he was late as usual. It isn't much of a house, is it?
We like it.
Then it doesn't take a lot to keep you happy. Look at the dust there. Oh, and there. Oh,
well, we are rather short-staffed at the moment.
Hasn't anyone ever cleaned those carpets?
No!
No, really, come off the shelf!
We'll shut up! And you must be the children. Pity. And then suppose you know who I am.
Yes, we do. You're the Holy Terror.
Impudent boy! And you're Jane, I suppose? Why aren't you wearing stockings?
I don't like them.
Bad! What manners! I can see there isn't a minute to lose.
Oh.
That bust.
This is the crime.
Brimstone and treacle and cod liver oil, liver doses of each. These are the treats from which children recoil, the lessons I'm going to teach. Just follow my model and don't mollycoddle. It may be irksome to irk. So seek satisfaction from punitive action. Brimstone and treacle will work.
Oh, Pen. Does it taste as bad as it smells?
Oh, worse.
Do I have to?
Well, I...
Oh,
Pen! Brimstone and treacle and carbolic soap. These are the tools of my trade. With spoonfuls of sugar, don't have a hope of seeing that changes are made. Where manners are chronic, my tincture's the tonic that's certain to wipe off a smirk. Just pour out a ration in matronly fashion. Brimstone and treacle will work. Your son will go to boarding school. Stand for whining or whinging or whimpering, crying or sighing or sobbing or simpering. I fear it's clear that in these two such bad habits loom. First the rat and tooth throttle, then uncork the bottle. Brimstone and treacle will work. Now, show me to my room.
Today, I'm a chimney sweep. Now, what's the matter and who's after you?
The nastiest nanny in the world.
The nastiest nanny in the world, eh? Well, you two should know. You've been through enough of them. Now, tell me, she's really as bad as all that?
She looks like something that would eat its young.
Miss Andrew is Daddy's nanny.
Which explains a lot.
Poor Daddy. Ever since he stopped working, he just sits and mopes. Mary Poppins used to say he needed our help. But now it's too late.
Oh, I wouldn't say all that. Here, I'll tell you what. How's about we start with a bit of a shake
for good luck.
Why would shaking hands with you bring us luck?
Hasn't anybody ever told you it's lucky to shake a sweep's hand?
Then what do you do when you want a luck?
Well, I shake hands with myself. Now, what have we got here?
Michael, look, it's a real one. What's the matter? You've always wanted to fly a proper kite.
I've always wanted to fly one with Daddy.
Of course you have. You just need to know how it's done. Get some practice in, and you'll make him the proudest father in the whole country.
You really think so? You're not just saying that.
Did I say the whole country? The whole blooming empire, more like. With tuppence for paper and strings, you can have your own set of wings. With your feet on the ground, you're a bird in flight, with your fist holding tight to the string of your kite. Oh, let's go fly your kite up to the highest height. Let's go fly your kite and send it soaring up through the atmosphere, up where the air is clear. Oh, let's go fly your kite.
What's this? We don't allow litter in this park.
It isn't litter, it's a kite.
Oh, it's a kite, is it? My word it is. I haven't flown a kite since I was a boy. Well, give her a one, wind her up and away she'll go.
I want to do it.
Oh, but you let me help, won't you? Seeing as though I haven't flown a kite since I was a boy.
So all right.
When you see it flying up there, all at once you're lighter than air. You can dance on the breeze over houses and trees with your fist holding tight to the string of your kite.
For sore eyes.
You really are. Welcome back, Mary Poppins.
See? I told you they were good kids, Mary.
And I told you they were worth bothering with.
Now see here! It's against regulations! Coming in from the sky like that. And where from, I'd like to know, eh? Where from?
If I were a park keeper, I should straighten my cap and button my coat. Come along, children.
Aren't you going to shake hands with Bert for luck?
No.
Why not? We have.
I don't need any luck, thank you.
Yeah!
Is anything the matter, Banks?
Illusions may shatter, but memories stay. The things that really matter I lost on the way. The sovereign, the master, and long may he reign. The famous good for nothing, Cherry Tree Lane.
They'll find their way home in no time. Let's face it, Mum. They've had plenty of practice at it.
Yes, but this time they weren't being naughty. I'm afraid I've made them unhappy. I'm afraid I've made everyone unhappy.
They'll find their way home. Don't you worry.
George, dear. I know it hurts your pride, dear. But you can't just run and hide, dear. Why can't you see that I'm here and I am on your side? Whenever you spoke of Miss Andrew, you showered the woman with praise. But now that I've met dear Miss Andrew, well, there are one of two things I'd rephrase. To think you were raised by that monster and carried that burden through life. If only you could see that you could share it with your wife. Being Mrs. Banks, it's easy to forget the way I felt that summer's day, the day when we first met. Being Mrs. Banks, being kissed by you, a man of dreams who made me feel that wishes could come true. And now, although you're lost, it's time that we close ranks. I'll fight for the man who needs freeing, the real you who no one is seeing, and you'll find a way of just
and not free in the skies for 2 years? How shameful. Yes, of course, that's a field I know well. An hour, no longer, your wings will grow stronger once you are free from this cell.
What kind of bird is it?
A lark. You are seeing a lark in a cage for the first time and the last. My pleasure. Don't mention it.
I'm going downstairs to fetch Caruso my lock. You stay there and clean the grate. Again? So, you've decided to come crawling back, have you? Well, I think we know what's needed now. Brimstone and treacle.
you're looking for?
Who are you?
I'm Mary Poppins.
Mary Poppins? But you left without notice.
And I've come back without notice.
I see. And what do you expect me to do?
Pack.
Pack! You insolent young person! How dare you speak to me in this way!
Silly little girl with your newfangled method. I bring up children so they know their place. Study for tradition, I govern my charges.
Mishandled charges blow up in your face.
I brought up their father.
Well, that I don't doubt. You must be so proud at the way he turned out.
A shining example, a pillar,
a post. They all have their problems, but him more than.
My little lark out of his cage. Now you will bear the full brunt of my rage.
Well, brimstone and treacle for you. Brimstone and treacle.
Just a spoonful of sugar.
Brimstone and treacle.
Just a spoonful of sugar.
Brimstone and treacle.
Just a spoonful of sugar.
Like that, and I should be as angry as anything if I weren't so pleased to see you. Now, where's Miss Andrew?
She's gone.
Gone? Why?
She didn't give a reason, Mum.
How peculiar. So, Mary Poppins, if you're back, are you going to stay?
I shall stay for as long as necessary, Mum.
Because the last time you were here, you left without a word of warning. How do I know you won't do it again?
You don't.
Oh.
Excuse me, Mom.
Oh, Constable, I'm so sorry I bothered you, but look, it's quite all right. They're back and...
Not all of them, Mum.
What?
We found this one, a wandering in the park. Good night, Mum.
George.
Where is she?
Miss Andrew? She left.
Left? But how?
She might have thought we were rude.
Rude? To Miss Andrew? Well, I can't forgive it. But I might try and forget it just this once. In fact, I'd have given you sixpence if I had any.
George, you haven't noticed. Mary Poppins is back.
Oh, well, well. Mary Poppins, I wonder if we might have a word. There's no point beating around the bush. Things have not gone well since you left us.
About my wages, sir. If you don't mind, I won't take any just now. I shall prefer to let them accrue.
But Mary Poppins, if only you knew how many payments were accruing as it is.
Is everything settled?
It is. Now I must get started. Michael, Jane, Spitzbot. Are the trains playing up? Or is Mrs. Brill cooking? Come along, darling. You made a wrong decision. How bad is that? Look, after many years of good service, what's the worst that could happen?
Winifred, if I am to be dismissed by the bank, we will be destitute. The servants will leave. The house will be repossessed. We'll be sitting outside with the children on the frosty curbside.
But we'll still have what really matters. The children and each other. When the time comes and not before.
You are going to stay with us this time, aren't you, Mary Poppins?
I shall stay until the chain breaks.
What chain? Where?
Michael, do be careful. The room is a little excited to see me back. And you never know what might happen around the park.
A chimney swept, a secret kept, up here among the gables. Another world to be unfurled with ages, myths and fables. A chimney stack looks cold and black beneath a twilight sky. But never fear, there's warmth up here, perhaps you'll find out why.
I look like? That's better.
The world is awfully big, isn't it?
And what does that tell you?
That we're awfully small and unimportant.
Oh, speak for yourself.
Not us so much, but our troubles. They seem so big down in the nursery. But up here...
Oh, that's more like it. You see... Things aren't as bad as they seem when looked at from a little higher up. And always remember, there's plenty of folks around should you need them.
Who?
Chim chiminy, chim chiminy, chim chim chari. Now guardian angels you don't often see. They're not highfalutin, nor grand, nor aloof. Nah! They're covered in soot and they're up on your roof. It's true!
Brush away the dirt and soot.
Brush away your tears.
Cobwebs that aren't swept away.
Hang on.
step in.
Step in time.
Never need a reason, never need a rhyme. We will step in.
Step in time.
Perfect crime, don't it seem a shame
when the steps aren't going as smoothly as they might? Hey!
anything. Come along, children.
It's happened. The chairman wants to see me at the close of business tonight.
Tonight? Well, I'm going to come with you and jolly well give that chairman a piece of my mind.
No, that would only make matters worse. We have to face it. In just a few hours, I'll have joined the ranks of the unemployed.
Oh, George, are you quite sure?
Quite sure. In fact, we need to make some plans and... I'm afraid the time has come.
Oh, you don't mean your mother's vase. Won't you miss it terribly?
Needs must, my dear. We always said we'd save it for a rainy day, and well, tomorrow it looks set to pour.
Oh, George, please do be careful.
Stars. And I hid them once from my nanny. I always knew I put them where no one would find them. Trouble is, I couldn't find them either.
They're very bright.
Aren't they? Even after all this time.
Here, let me give you a hand.
I used to dream, when I grew up, I'd learn everything there was to know about the stars. Funny. I haven't thought about that in years. I'm not usually so sentimental.
It's good to look back sometimes.
Is it? I'm not so sure. A man has dreams of walking with giants to carve his niche in the edifice of time. Before the mortar of his zeal has the chance to congeal. The cup is dashed from his lips. His flame is snuffed a morning. He's brought to wreck and ruin in his prime.
That's a rum go, Governor. Ain't that the truth?
You know what I think? It's all that Mary Poppins' fault. Since the moment she walked into this house, things have begun happening to me.
Mary Poppins, eh?
Yes, Mary Poppins. My life was calm, well-ordered, exemplary. And there came this person with chaos in her wake. And now my life's ambitions go in one fell blow. It's quite a bitter pill to take. It's that Poppins woman. She's responsible for all of this.
I know the very person. What's that thing she's always saying? A spoonful of sugar goes a long, long way. It changes bread and water into tea and cakes. A spoonful of sugar goes a long, long way. So have yourself an healthy helping every day.
Trouble, if you ask me.
It's like you're always saying, Governor. you've got to grind, grind, grind at that grindstone. Though childhood slips like sand through a sieve, and all at once they've up and grown, and then they've flown, and you've got nothing left to give, just that spoonful of sugar to help the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Well, good luck, Governor.
Good luck, Bert. And thank you.
Father?
What is it?
We've come to say goodnight.
Ah. Yes. Good night.
Daddy, do you remember when we came to the bank?
Yes.
Well, we were each given a sixpence, and we were told to spend them carefully.
That's excellent advice. It's exactly what you should do. What did you buy with them?
Nothing yet. We kept them. And now I've decided to give them to you.
I suppose Mary Poppins put you up to this?
No, she hasn't said a word about it. But we know it's been difficult for you lately, and we haven't really been much help.
So, we thought a little bit of extra cash might loosen things up a little.
It is a whole shilling.
Thank you.
Good night, Daddy. We do love you, you know.
Jane, Do you remember you asked me once who Neleus' father was?
Yes.
Well, it's Poseidon, king of the sea. Good night.
Loves you very much, and that's far more important than jobs or houses or anything else.
Are you going to the bank with him?
Well, I wish he'd let me, but he won't. But if there was someone to speak up for him, to take his part, to show them what he's really like inside.
Why can't he do that for himself?
Because he's a man. And a very proud one.
Then you must go.
Well, I'd like to, but I'm afraid it just isn't possible.
Why?
Because I'm a woman.
Mary Poppins says anything is possible. If we can only get out of our own way.
Do you really believe that, Mary Poppins? Anything can happen if you let it. Sometimes things are difficult, but you can bet it doesn't have to be so.
Changes can be made. You can move a mountain if you use a larger spade.
Anything can happen, it's a marvel.
You can be a butterfly
or just a larval.
Stretch your mind beyond.
I wonder.
Any.
anything can happen if you let it.
You won't know a challenge until you've met it.
No one does it for you.
No one but yourself. Vacillating violets get left up on the shelf. Anything can happen, just imagine.
That should be my epitaph. I wear the badge in honor.
Those who see beyond their blinkers.
Jelly isn't jelly
till you set it.
Anything can happen if you let it.
If you reach for the stars, all you get are the stars. But we found a whole new spin. If you reach for the heavens, you get the stars.
A bag. Paid the birds, sir. Only tuppence a bag.
I would take it as a great favor if you would kindly feed them for me.
Tuppence, tuppence, tuppence a bag.
Precision and order. Paying one's debts. Risking our investments, hedging our bets.
Mr. Banks is here.
Come in, Banks.
Trading in futures. Jobs on the line.
Well, Banks, how did it happen you turned down a scheme that was bound to make millions? And we want to know why.
Well, I'll tell you. I refused Mr. Von Hustler because his scheme was hollow. He had no product, he had no substance, it had no meaning outside the walls of the bank. Oh, yes, he told me about the profit and the assets and the growth, but there wasn't a word about the people. I know that if you think that if anybody puts any value on real life, then as far as you're concerned, he's a washout. But I'm afraid I do value it, gentlemen. In short, George Banks Esquire has rediscovered the human race. Oh, I apologize if I ruin the bank, but I will not apologize for understanding that there is more important things in life than just making money.
Oh, ruining the bank. Ruining the bank. My dear chap, what are you talking about? You've saved our bacon. Well, haven't you heard? Von Hustler's scheme has ruined our rival. You've kept us out of the nastiest scandal since records began. We don't want your apologies. We're offering ours.
Oh, my word!
And another thing. Do you remember giving a loan to a fellow called Northbrook?
Yes.
Well, he's repaying it and opening two new factories. And with the percentage you negotiated, we look set to make a fortune.
Huzzah! Oh, my word!
Well, that's just it. We very much hope that you might tell us how you did it. Just give us the word. It'll be quite safe with us.
Give you the word? Give you the word?
Yes. Yes.
Oh, I'll give you a word, all right. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious!
Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious!
Oh, thank you, sir!
Now, Banks!
Forgive him! It's not his fault. It's all because of his nanny, Miss Andrew.
The holy terror! She taught me everything I know.
And now's your chance to forget it.
That's right. And if you want to fight about it, then you've come to the right woman.
Oh, it's all right. It's all right, darling. I didn't lose the bank any money at all. In fact,
I made them a fortune.
Yes,
gentlemen, madam, if you please, we still have some business to conduct. Banks, George, by way of recompense, we'd like to offer you the job of a senior manager with a salary at double.
Exactly how much has he made for you?
Triple, quadruple your present rate.
George, close your mouth. We are not a codfish.
Well,
I accept. But I must make one thing clear. From now on, my family comes first.
Agreed?
Agreed. Winifred, how can you ever forgive me?
How can you ask?
It was selfish of me to keep you off the stage, and you'll want to go back, and I won't mind if I do.
I loved it, but I found a role I'd much rather prefer. And it's going to keep me extremely busy for a very long time.
Turn it on its head, then pirouette it. Anything can happen if you let it.
If you reach for the stars, all you get are the stars. But we've held a whole new spin. If you reach for the heavens, you get the stars, the
moon as well. Of course.
And Mary Poppins, that was the best yet. To be up in the heavens, think we'll ever go back there?
Yes. Someday.
Really? Will it be soon?
Oh, no. Not for a very long time. But you can always keep an eye on the stars until you return. Here.
But it's your telescope.
So it is. Keep it if you like. It's a present.
Thank you.
Now run along in. It's getting cold.
I love you, Mary Poppins.
You are a fine boy, Michael Banks. And one day you will be a fine man.
And Mary Poppins, it makes me so anxious when you talk like that.
Like what?
All gentle and kind, not a bit like you. Be cross again, Mary Poppins, do be cross.
Is that the thanks I get for all the trouble I've taken?
That's better.
That's dainty, Bert.
They're yours. I drew them. For you. It's tonight, isn't it?
Yes, Bert.
Well, goodbye, Mary.
Goodbye, Bert. Look after yourself. Perfect. And I hope it remains so.
What's happened? Something's changed. The bed's gone.
Locket. Oh, the chain's broken.
Don't you remember? I'll stay until the chain breaks.
There's a note too.
What does the note say?
Michael had the telescope, so this is for you. It's a picture of the three of us.
And it's signed, Mary Poppins with a good deal of love.
Mary Poppins?
She's gone.
Gone? How peculiar.
She'll be back. Now what do you think of this one?
It's the best I've ever seen!
Do you think we could fly it together?
Oh, Daddy.
Mary Poppins won't be coming back. She's gone. Forever.
My dear, how could you possibly know such a thing?
Because we don't need her. Not anymore. And other families will. Won't they, Daddy?
I wonder if she's right, George, and we really could do without a nanny from now on.
What do you think?
I think you should come and dance with me.
This is serious.
Wish on it, children. My dearest love.